Welcome to the SME 2-Minute Drill, where we cover a ThoughtSpot feature in 2 minutes or less. In this video, we're covering the group aggregate formula. The clock is running, so let's get started. So the group aggregate formula is more flexible than the other grouping functions in that it's able to group specific formulas as well as provide a filter on top of them. So if we have, in this case, two store regions, west and east, and three stores belonging to these regions, we have the regular formula for sales where it's just filtered down based off of the store. But what if I wanted to get the region sales for these specific stores? So what I can do is pass the group aggregate formula and give it sum of sales, store region as the grouping, and then use query filters to filter on it from the search bar. Now, if we wanted to just get all of the region sales, regardless of the store filters, we can do the same formula, but leave the third parameter blank. Now, what if we wanted to get all company sales, regardless of any filtering or grouping? Well, you could still provide that group aggregate for sum of sales, but you would leave the last two parameters blank. And finally, for the total report sales, let's say that we want the total for all three of these combined. So what we would do is that we would give it a sum of sales, leave the middle parameter blank, but still pass the query filters so we can filter based off of these three stores. So if you guys would like to follow along with our 2-minute drill, you can download this exact data set from our website at the link below. Until next time, this has been a SME 2-minute drill for ThoughtSpot.